On the last weekend of June of this year, a group of friends from Cody Rafting decided to go on a quick overnight trip. We arrived at the put-in to the Gunnison Gorge, and once we had our gear all sorted, we made our way through the desert down towards the river. Earlier in the day, a mule had taken our boats down for us, which made the hike for us quite a bit easier, as we didn't have to carry anything but our own personal gear.
Which way will you run when it's always all around you, and the feeling lost and found you again, a feeling that we have no control?
On this trip, we'd all decided to use small 8.5-foot rafts called Minimis. They're made by the manufacturer Highside, and they're the smallest boat around. They're also endearingly known as Pickles. The Gunnison Gorge itself officially begins at the bottom of the Black Canyon, but in reality is just a continuation of it. The gorge runs through miles and miles of spectacular and pristine Colorado wilderness, and the park that it's located in encompasses nearly 63,000 acres of protected land, which is managed by the Bureau of Land Management.
We're too proud of. I want to take the preconceived out from underneath your feet. We could shake it off and instead we'll plant some seeds.
Once we arrived at the beach where we would camp for the night, we did what raft guides do best. We shotgunned some beers.
The branches, will they reach for?
And of course Mike, the only non-raft guide out of the whole group, was the winner.
But underneath it all, there's this heart.
After a couple more beers and a lot of nonsense, we thought maybe piling 8 people into a boat designed for 3 was a great idea, and ran the Class 3 Rapid just below our camp.
Really won't be so long. Sometimes it feels like a heart is no place to be singing.
Although it didn't end there. Of course, we had to run the rapid upside down, backwards, and every which way before we were totally satisfied.
There's a world we've never seen. There's still hope between the dreams. The weight of it all could blow away with a breeze. If you're waiting on the wind, don't forget to breathe.
The following morning, we woke up to another beautiful, sunny, blue sky Colorado day. Packed up our boats, and we got back on the water. In the last week of June is when the stoneflies hatch, and they were in a frenzy, flying around everywhere, and they were landing all over our gear, on our boats, on our paddles, and in our ears. But we got through it, and we arrived at Boulder Garden Rapid, probably the most difficult Class 3 rapid that we were going to encounter during the trip.
This love be the fading sky. We could drift all night into the new sunrise. Pass me a drink or maybe two. One for me and one for you. And we'll be free. We've been dropping them sails and get inside.
Once we got through Boulder Garden, we had a little bit of time to relax, and we had ourselves some lunch. We also floated through a bit of flat water, and after all that fresh air, some of us just needed a cigarette. And some more of us needed a cigarette. But for Andrea, all she wanted was some granola, of course.
There's nothing in between what we are, what we see. There's nothing in between what we are, what we see, what we are. We are just on a lifeboat sailing home with our drunken hearts and our tired bones. Will I just take one last look around?
Yeah, and every place feels like a familiar town.
And now we're free.
But like all good things, our journey had to come to an end. So we deflated our boats, packed them up, and we said goodbye to the Gunnison Gorge.